The following is a 24 hours podcast.
I'm Tim Edwards.
I'm Dan Saitua.
And we're with Crash Pello, and you're watching the 24 hours podcast.
And the mention of God makes me strange. The battle of words and the wars we wage, and the castles of time we build up straight, just to run out of room and we build sideways.
A blustery spring day in Vancouver, Granville Island, and we're talking to a couple of members of Crash Parallel. This is Tim and Dan. Welcome to Vancouver.
Thank you. Thank you. Welcome.
First time here?
Yes. Actually,
no,
we were here a little while ago. Doing radio promos for about a week, so second time for me.
So now being on the left coast, how do you find it?
It's a lot warmer.
Well, not today, it's not.
Yeah.
Still so, probably a little bit warmer.
Yeah. Nicer. So, yeah, I love it here. It's great.
Yeah, we came down earlier. We met with The Beat here in Vancouver. And a lot of the radio stations jumped on board with the single right away. So they've actually brought us back out here today, or recently, to do a show. So we've done that. And
the single World We Know, title track from the album.
You got it.
And the album has just come out.
Yep.
How much of a sense of accomplishment do you guys feel? Because there's not a lot of Canadian acts that are being signed in this country by major labels. That must be pretty cool for you guys.
It is pretty cool, and I think from a sense of accomplishment, we've been working on music a long time and never really had a completed project, and then when we had it, it was like, well, what are we doing with this? And then in a very short period of time, we went from to nothing, to minor label, to major label within like a four-month period, which was pretty incredible. So we're really thankful that we get to do that, and yeah, Sony's been great. And it seems like a rarity. A lot of people are saying that to us, you know, like, this never happens.
Well, it doesn't happen a whole lot.
Yeah, well, you know what I mean.
Yeah.
It doesn't happen a whole lot, especially with the way the industry's going. But, you know, there's hope, and especially, you know, I think Canadian music has been always as strong internationally. It's always been a big contributor. So we hope to be a part of that, for sure.
Give us the deep introspective story behind the name Crash Parallel.
Actually, Tim should probably explain this because he came up with it.
Okay. Deep and introspective. I think my life, I've always been trying to get to this point of where I have everything in place, which is the parallel to me. Every time I got close, there was a crash that would occur in my life to sort of throw me off that parallel track. The songs deal with a lot of the crashes and how you go through it emotionally. That's sort of where the name originated. So that's the whole idea about it. It's kind of dealing with those crashes and realizing that the parallel life is really boring, and that the crashes are where most of us can relate and feel things that are real. So
let's talk about your personal influences, because when people hear Crash Parallel, they're evoking images of other artists. What were your individual influences?
Well, I think from the beginning, some of the songs I started writing were very folk-based. Some of my influences would be in the area of like Pearl Jam, Counting Crows, stuff like that. And then I brought these simple folk songs to Dan, and he sort of, at the time, one of your influences, I think, was Coldplay. You had an influence there.
Tons of influence.
You added to the music.
Yeah, basically, I mean, as a musician, regular influences, being a guitar player like Jimi Hendrix, guys like that. Played guitar for a long time. Then I kind of got away from the rock scene, started producing hip-hop and house. I used to play in a band with Tim in high school. We stopped. I started producing hip-hop and house, and then he came to me with these folk songs. And my influences with that producing kind of helped us produce the record and layer it. So there's a lot of different elements that go into our sound. So
is it hard when you're in a band to have like a collaborative vision, because you all have individual influences and ideas? How do you kind of hone in on what it is we're going to focus on?
We got lucky. In a sense that I needed someone to take the songs to the next level, and it happened to be Dan. But the biggest thing for us was we were uncompromising, and if we had battles about what was going to work and what wasn't, we were very good about it. There wasn't any ego. He could tell me straight up, like, that you can't hit that note, or, you know, we're not going to do this, it's not going to go that way. And I'd, you know, I'm kind of stubborn, and I'd be like, well, I like it. And we just worked through it really well without having any animosity. And I think that's one of the great things about the whole band, is none of us have that sort of, you know, we're not fighting each other to make what we're making. We're just uncompromising, and we all love it, and that's really the
goal,
key.
The main goal is all about the song. Like, as musicians, we all know our role. Each song, it starts with Tim. He has a story to tell. So as musicians, when you're trying to come up with your part, you want to write something that matches the mood, right? Just to create the overall sense of the song and basically what he's trying to say in the song. So
was it lightning in a bottle immediately, or was there a point in the evolution of the band where you kind of went, you know what, we're onto something here?
Funny, Dan actually wasn't in on the project when I first came to him, but he said he would record it for me. I had to work. I had 1 hour. I laid down the bed track with him, and I left. And the next day, he handed me a CD, and it was like this whole new world of melody and everything, and I was like, wow. So I think Lightning in a Bottle was there right off the bat. By the second song, we knew we had something that we wanted to work on and take to the next level. And so I would say definitely there was lightning in a bottle.
We're going to see a Vancouver tour date very soon here. What is Crash Parallel like live? What can we expect?
You can expect a full-on rock show, but with some of the intimacy of getting in behind the stories. You know, I'll talk about a few of where the stories came from. And it's kind of like one of these, you know, you're going to be introduced with like a nice heavy rock show. But then you're also going to come down to where it's just me and the piano and you know, some ballad stuff. And so it's a bit of a roller coaster ride, but on the whole, I think it's a nice toned down rock show.
And whipping the fans into frenzy, like we see in Room Keys and thongs being thrown on stage and stuff?
Perhaps.
<Not yet. laughs> Hopefully soon.
I don't think you'll see a mosh pit, but you definitely see people singing and grooving. And that's, yeah, I mean, we'll see. But I, you know, my perception is that, you know, get people that are into it and having a good time and who can really sort of sit back and go, wow, and then get into it and kind of move around and have a good time. Do my dance for me.
Do you make a conscious effort to plan out a course of action, or do you just kind of see where this thing goes? Like, for example, if you had a 5-year mission? If we have this conversation five years from now, what's going on?
In 5 years, we're putting out our 5th record. And making our 17th video, and, you know.
The best stuff is already out at this point?
Yeah.
Okay.
No, the best of isn't already out. I think some of the stuff we're working on for the second record already, we're really excited about. You know, there's songs we wish were on this record that weren't because thematically they didn't fit, but we loved them as songs.
But that's a good problem when you can't.
It's a great problem. Yeah.
More
it's a great
problem.
It's a great problem. Yeah. You know, we have the publishing wing going, you know, just send us those songs. We'll try and use them, and you know. We have a lot of good material, and I don't think this is by any means the pinnacle of what we have, but we're really proud of the record, and I think the next record is something we're really going to look forward to.
A solid record too, called World We Know, Crash Parallel, out now, available in record stores near you. Thanks for showing it.
Thank you.
Vancouver.24hours.ca